Hey, this is Robert from Virtual Set FX, and I am going to show you how to use our new Global News Studio background. Let me let it play here for a little bit so you can kind of see what we're going to do. The animation is basically a virtual studio background that you use in any kind of green screen or chroma key video production. You can use it for having a presenter and then placing a background there and then having a video or image or sequence show up kind of in this drop-down monitor area there. I'm using Premiere Pro CC, but you can use any video editor that can do green screen or chroma key video production. So Final Cut, Premiere, Vegas or Sony Movie Studio, After Effects, that kind of thing. Any of those video editors or motion graphics programs can use these backgrounds. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to delete out everything that we have in here, so you can see me do everything from scratch. So let me select everything there and whatnot. And so if you're in Premiere, then you would basically just set up a new project. This workflow will work for, you know, any other video editor. Things may be a little set up a little differently in your video editor, but the basic ideas of importing and chroma keying and that kind of thing are the same. And so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to set up a new folder for our backgrounds. We'll call this our Virtual Studios there, and then I will grab all of our backgrounds that you get with the studio and select them all and then click and drag them into that Virtual Studio folder right there. And then the second thing I'm going to do is bring in our footage of our green screen talent lady. And so I'll click and drag a piece of green screen footage. I'm just going to put it in the top level here. So you can see that. And then I'm also going to bring in just a generic piece of footage that we're going to use that's going to show up in the drop down monitor that comes down on the studio. Let me see if I can bring in this video here. You can kind of see there's a bunch of different setups with this studio. You've got kind of a center animated monitor. You've got kind of that look there. And let's see what else we have. Just a loop there, and then one with a center animated and left animated. I think I'm going to use that one right there. And so I'm going to click this file here, and in Premiere you can just click and drag down to either the timeline there or click this little create new timeline, drag it over there, and that'll make a new timeline for you right there. All of the animations that have a drop-down monitor are all loopable. So they loop at 3 seconds and 15 frames. So if you go to 3:15 on your timeline and slice your clip right there, then this section of the clip right there is repeatable and loopable. And so you can just copy that section of the clip and paste it on the down timeline for as long as you need, and then the seams where the clip comes together, those are just seamless. So you can basically just leave this monitor down and have it down there for your talent to be on top of. So the next thing that I'm going to do is bring our talent down onto the timeline. And so we'll have her show up right there. And so if you are if you're familiar with adding a key to your footage, then just, you know, do that now. In Premiere, you have a couple of different keying options. You can go to this effects window, click this little video effects tab, and then find keying. Another quicker way to do it is to use this little search bar right there. Just type in K-E-Y for key. And that'll bring you a blue screen key, you know, all the different keys, that keying options that you have in Premiere. I like Ultra Key, and so if you click that effect and drag it onto your talent footage layer, Then you get your effects controls area right here. You'll see that Ultra Key shows up. Quickest way to get a key from your footage is just to click this little eyedropper tool. Click the green of your background right there, and then it should take the green out of the scene. And you may, you know, you may have to make some adjustments and that kind of thing to make it work for your whatever shot you have, but it generally does a pretty decent job. If you're just trying to do it quickly, this little setting right here where you can drop down, you can do an aggressive key, and that will key out a wider range of the color that you've chosen with the color picker, and just kind of you know, do a pretty good job of it there. So you see that that we have our talent now, and she's on top of our background, and then we have our animated monitor that comes down and whatnot there. And so the next thing that we're going to do is to apply a key to the studio layer. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete out where I had sliced off the animations there. That way I don't have to apply the chroma key to all these different clips here. And I'll just extend this out to the links of it there. So I'm going to drag Ultra Key onto the Global News background, and then use the color picker to choose the green in the drop-down monitor. And then you'll see that it'll knock right out there, just like that. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to select both of these clips right here, and I'm going to move them up a level. So we have video 1, 2, and 3. I'm going to move the talent up to layer 3, and the studio to layer 2, and then studio 1 will actually be our background animation or graphics or video or whatever you're going to throw into this drop-down monitor there. So let me select these two clips, just drag them up like that, and then I will bring in our little piece of footage right there, and then I'm actually going to unlink the audio and video, right click and then unlink, and then that way I can delete that audio because we're not going to be using it right there. So if I go a little further into the clip, you can see that our footage shows up. It's, you know, about that size right there. I think it's 720p maybe. It's about right there. And so what we're going to need to do is scale it and position it so that it shows up in this monitor area right there. And so to do that in Premiere, you just select your clip, go to motion, scale it down a bit, and then you can position it using the little sliders like so. And so that's, you know, not a bad positioning of the clip. You can see it kind of comes down and whatnot there. What you can even do is you can even kind of mimic this this kind of angled monitor area here if you want to. And you do that by applying a simple 3D effect. So if you come over to your effects browser right there and you type in 3D, there's a perspective effect, basic 3D. Click that, drag it onto your B-roll footage. And then now you have some options in your effects controls where you can swivel, tilt, that kind of thing. And so we'll swivel it just a little bit, just kind of slide it to the side, maybe about right there. And then now we'll reposition, scale our clip up a little bit. Right, about right there. And so now we've got it kind of angled a little bit that kind of matches the way the monitor moves and that kind of thing. And so if I click, and once you see it, you can kind of see the way the scene works and whatnot there. And so kind of like what I mentioned, you know, you can have, you can slice your global news background at 3 seconds and 15 frames, and then duplicate it for as long as your presentation is, and then that will keep this screen down, and you can do your thing there. One thing that is a little easier to do when you're doing a longer, maybe B-roll sequence, maybe that times into the person that's talking right there, because what'll happen is, you know, if you bring another clip down onto the timeline, you know, and you're maybe editing with the background right there. Every time you bring another clip down, you're gonna have to, you know, add a 3D transition, scale it, move it, position it, that kind of thing. And so a good little trick to avoid that is to set up a new sequence that is just for your B-roll, just for this video footage that shows up in this area right here. So if I go new item, new sequence, we'll call this one our B-roll sequence. Click OK. All right. And so if I bring down my footage, you know, I can bring that one, and that one. And a lot of times what I'll do is I'll just isolate the audio from the main presenter and bring it into this sequence, and then edit all of my B-roll or my graphics or text or anything like that into this sequence, and then and cut everything the way it needs to be, the way it needs to show up on the screen. And so then once you have it completely cut to your timed to your presenter, then you can bring the sequence, I'll delete this piece of footage there, you can bring the sequence down onto the down onto this third timeline, and now you can just scale and position this one sequence with all of your clips contained inside of it, and you can scale it, move it, you know, apply the 3D effect to it, scale it up just a hair and whatnot. And now you can all you have to do is do it that one time, and then all of your all of the pieces that make up that little B-roll sequence are all going to be scaled, positioned, and moved in the correct place, so that you don't have to do it 50 times if you have 50 different graphics or different pieces of footage that show up and that kind of thing. So that's kind of a cool way of doing things. Let me show you some other backgrounds from this series. This particular one has, let me see how many does it have in there. Let's see, it's got about 23 different backgrounds that you can choose from to kind of see to use for your first studios and that kind of thing. So you can see, if I click here, you can kind of see that there's different, there's one that's kind of more of a centered position. Some that have this kind of background area here where you can change out the graphics that show up in this area right there. Even has some reflections and stuff that maybe you can show up right in there. So maybe I'll show you how to do that on this next one. So on this one, let me clear out everything on my timeline there. And then I'm going to drag this down to the second layer right there. And so we have, this one is just a perfect loop. So there's no drop down monitors or anything like that. And so you could just copy it and paste it, you know, down your timeline for as long as you need. And then it'll, you know, just repeat over and over and over again down your timeline. So let me first apply a ultra key effect. So we'll go over to the effects, type in key, find our ultra key plugin, drag that onto our studio, use the eyedropper, select it, knock the green out of the scene there, and you see it knocks out there, 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 and there. And so now we will take a piece of footage. You know, I think I'm actually just going to use a motion graphic to make it maybe look a little cooler right there. So let me drag this, import this little motion, this little breaking news motion graphic that I've got. And so if I drag that down, you can kind of see where it shows up in the background. So I'll select it and then go to our effects controls, motion, scale it down, kind of reposition it a little bit. You know, I could add that 3D key to it. Scale it up a hair. Like that, maybe. And so you can see we can get the we get our little motion graphic in the background right there, which looks pretty nice. But then we also have this little reflection area to work with right here. And so let me just move my stuff up a layer here so I have another layer at the bottom. And so I'm going to copy and paste onto this bottom layer. So now we have two instances of this animation right there. And so what I'm going to do, actually you can do this a couple of different ways. I'm going to flip this this clip vertically so that I can have a reflection down at the bottom here. And so the way I'm going to do that is, easiest way to do this, even easier, is to go to your effects controls right there, go to flip, type in flip in the little search bar, and then we will do a vertical flip on the on this clip. So we'll drag this vertical flip effect over to our bottom layer right there, and that will flip our piece of footage. And then if I position it down a little ways, then you can see that it's showing up in this little reflection area. You see how it's blue right there, it's blue right there. It's been vertically flipped on itself. And so now if I play that through, then you can see we get a nice little reflection kind of in the floor area. And then you can do different things. You can, you know, if that's a little bit too bright of a reflection for the bottom there, which it might be for somebody, then you can change the opacity of that layer right there so that maybe it's not quite so bright. Maybe it's a little bit more subdued, you know, maybe about 30% or so there. And you can kind of see that we get a little bit of hint of movement right there at the bottom. And you basically would do the same thing for this monitor area over here. You would me add a few tracks to my timeline so that we can add two more tracks for a thing there and then a reflection there. So in Premiere, you right click, go to add tracks. We're gonna add two video tracks, no audio tracks there. And so we get five total video tracks. I'm going to click and move our other tracks up to the top so I can use the two on the bottom. And then I'm going to copy both of these first video tracks, this one and the reflection, and paste them down here. Right. And then this top one, I'm going to position and move it behind. You can kind of see, I'll show you. Kind of see where they are in the background there, but I'm gonna scale it down a bit. Like that, and then do the same thing with the reflection. I'll scale it down and then move it. Over. Where are you, bugger? Oh, there he is. Okay. Kind of hide my backgrounds there a little bit because I could not find where it went. There, so I'll scale him down, position him over a little bit, and then just kind of generally put him over there like that. So I turn everybody back on, and now you can see we've got our background video going. We replaced it with our own animations right there, and then we've got you know, some reflections showing up in the bottom and whatnot. So yeah, so pretty cool little thing. And that's about it. If you know, if you have any questions or anything, feel free to get in touch with us on our site. Otherwise, thanks for watching, and hope to hear from you soon. Thanks.